And I am 6 years old. Me and my friends have lots of questions about the coronavirus, so we have sent them to the scientists at Telethon Kids. And these are their answers.
Hi, my name is Matt and I'm 5 years old. I want to know how it feels like when you get coronavirus.
It's a good question. What does it feel like to get coronavirus? Well, coronavirus is a respiratory virus that infects the nose and the throat. So similar to other respiratory viruses, it can cause a temperature, fevers, it can cause a sore throat and a runny nose and sometimes cough. In some people, it can affect the lungs. So in those people, they may get breathlessness and they might get some chest pain.
Hi, I'm Georgie. I'm 12 years old and I want to know what I can do to help protect my friends and family from the coronavirus.
Children are asking, how can I help protect my friends and family from coronavirus? Well, to think about this, I want you to think about two things. How do you protect yourself, but also how do you protect those around you? Protecting yourself is about making sure that you don't pick up this germ. So it's making sure you wash your hands, washing them effectively with soap or water or an alcohol hand rub for a good 20 seconds and making sure there's no germs on your hands. Importantly, trying to avoid touching your nose and your mouth and your eyes, because germs can go from your hands to your mouth. Things that you can do to protect your friends and family are things such as making sure if you're unwell, staying away from them. If you've got sneezes and coughs, covering up those sneezes with a tissue or coughing into your elbow. And importantly, staying away from those people most vulnerable. And for coronavirus, that's the older people in our community. Trying to stay away from them until you're well, you're back to your normal self, so that you don't spread the virus from you to others.
Hi, my name's Harper and I'm 7 years old. I have a question for you. Why are so many things banned, like going on holidays, going to the movies and sports?
Many children are disappointed that things are being cancelled at the moment. I'm disappointed about that. My children are disappointed about that too. However, it's really, really important that we do this. We know that coronavirus is spreading from people to people around the globe. And we need to slow its spread. We need to slow its spread to try and make sure that we can protect the most amount of people. And to slow its spread, we need to limit contact between people. And the way we do that is to try and stop big gatherings, people getting together, which is an opportunity for the virus to jump from person to person to person. So, yes, it is disappointing that things are being cancelled at the moment, but this is a short-term issue to try and limit a very big problem that we've got at the moment.
Hi, my name is Emily. I'm 6 years old. I want to know why people get sicker than others with coronavirus.
Some people are getting really sick with coronavirus. For most people, it is a mild infection causing sore throat, runny nose, and fever, and many need to stay home from school or work for a couple of days. But for some people are getting really unwell with the coronavirus. It's affecting their lungs, making it difficult for them to breathe, needing for them to go to hospital, and sometimes need very intensive treatments. Fortunately, some people are dying from coronavirus, and that makes us very worried. And so we need to do everything we can to try and make sure that those in our community most vulnerable are protected. We need to slow the spread of this virus as it moves throughout our community and make sure you protect yourself by doing some of those simple things that I've talked about.
Hi, I'm Imogen, and I'm 13 years old, and what I want to know is why do some countries have more cases of the coronavirus than other countries?
Some countries have more coronavirus than others at this stage, you're right. It started in China, and so that's the country that's been heavily hit, and then moved to other countries such as Iran and Italy that have got major problems with coronavirus at the moment. In Australia, so far, we've got a relatively small number of people with coronavirus, but it is growing and is expected to continue to grow. So we need to do whatever we can to try and limit its spread in the community. So that means focusing on keeping well, doing some of the simple tasks that I've talked about, and importantly, making sure that we don't get together in big groups, making sure that we separate from each other so that we can stop the spread of this virus.
I have a question. Is there going to be a medicine for the coronavirus?
Do we have treatments? That's a really good question. So for most people with coronavirus, we don't need any treatments. They get better without any treatment. Yes, they're unwell for a couple of days with fever and sore throat and cough, but they get better. For a small proportion of people, a small group of people who are going to hospital will often use other treatments. We'll help them with their breathing, such as oxygen. We'll give them other drugs, including some antibiotics to try and help any bacterial infection of their lungs. But the problem is we don't have a specific medicine that targets the coronavirus at this stage. We're looking very hard to see where there are specific medicines against this virus that can try and improve the outcomes of those who get it. But so far, we do not have any specific medicines for this virus. We have lots of work to do.
Hi, my name is Billy. I'm 6 years old. I want to know if the coronavirus will eventually go away.
So will this coronavirus go away? Yes, it will, but I don't know how long it's going to be with us. It is likely to be with us for months and maybe even years as it moves through our community. For those who have been infected by this virus, it's unlikely that they will get it again. And so the number of people in our community who are susceptible to the virus will decrease over time until the point where it no longer circulates. I expect this is some way off, and we're going to have to monitor very closely as it moves through our community. And we need to do everything in our power to try and slow its spread. So the things I've talked about, some of those simple rules that I've talked about to try and slow its spread in the community. Simple things such as hand washing, covering sneezes and coughs, staying away while you're unwell, and staying away from those people most vulnerable to this infection. For those who get this infection, staying at home to make sure that others around you don't get it. They're the simple things that we can do to slow and stop this infection. I'm hoping that you can help me do that too.
Thank you, Dr. Chris, for answering our questions about the coronavirus.